Let's talk about the issue of ice forming on the suction pipe of an air conditioner. We'll discuss the reasons behind this problem and explain it for both inverter and non-inverter air conditioners. First, let's talk about the non-inverter air conditioner. The customer sent us pictures showing ice forming on the suction pipe. They explained that initially the AC provides cooling, but after a while, the airflow becomes significantly reduced. So let's look into the main reason behind this issue and understand what causes it. In the first step, I checked the refrigerant pressure. Initially, we measure the standing pressure, which is around 140 psi. This is neither too low nor too high. It's within an acceptable range. After that, we started the unit. The compressor is running, and the fan motor is also operating properly. After 10 to 15 minutes of operation, no ice formation is observed on the suction pipe. The ice usually starts forming after about 1 hour. At this point, the suction pressure was measured, and it showed 60 psi, which is perfectly normal for a 1-ton unit. Therefore, at this stage, there doesn't seem to be any issue with the gas pressure. The customer mentioned that the evaporator was cleaned just a week ago. However, during my inspection, I found that the entire evaporator was completely clogged. To confirm, I dismantled it to check its condition in detail. Upon examination, all the fins of the evaporator were blocked. This severe blockage has drastically reduced the blower's suction capacity, which is why the fan is making unusual noises during operation. Now, I have removed the indoor unit from the wall for cleaning. As we started dismantling it, the dirt became more evident. The water collector was full of debris, and when the evaporator was removed, its backside was completely clogged with dust. This severe accumulation of dirt is a clear indication of inadequate or improper cleaning previously. Now the unit has been fully serviced. First, we installed the blower fan, followed by the motor. After that, the cover was fixed. Then the evaporator was thoroughly cleaned and reinstalled. The PCB and the swing motor were also installed, and now the unit is ready for installation. Now that the unit has been reinstalled, the question is, how can we confirm that it is working properly? The most obvious indicator is its air throw. Previously, the unit could barely throw air up to 1 foot, but now it is throwing air up to 10 feet. This significant improvement in air throw is the best sign that the unit has been successfully repaired and serviced. Additionally, it confirms that the suction pipe will no longer accumulate ice, ensuring the unit operates efficiently. Now let's discuss the second reason why ice forms on the suction pipe, and I will also explain how you can easily identify and resolve this fault. First, let's look into the reason behind this issue. In 1.5 ton and 2 ton units, the system is controlled by a PCB, but in 1 ton and some 1.5 ton units, there is often a relay-based system. Here, we are dealing with a 20 ampere relay. What happens frequently is that the relay's points get stuck. When this occurs, the compressor continues to run continuously without cycling off. Due to this, the system overworks, and as a result, ice starts to form on the suction and discharge pipes. This is a common issue caused by a faulty relay, and identifying it is straightforward once you check the relay's condition. Now let me explain the system used in 2-ton and 2.5 ton units. These units operate similarly, but there are some key differences in the components. In 1-ton and 1.5 ton units, the relay directly handles the load of the compressor. However, in 2-ton and 2.5 ton units, smaller relays are used, but the same function and procedure apply. The difference is that these units use a contactor to manage the compressor's load. Two types of contactors are commonly used: 32 ampere two-pole contactor, 32 ampere single-pole contactor. The main difference is that the single-pole contactor has one set of connections, while the two-pole contactor has two. These contactors are mostly used in larger units to handle the higher load. The relay in these systems is responsible for activating the contactor, which in turn powers the compressor. This system ensures efficient operation and prevents overloading of the relay. To easily identify whether the relay or contactor is stuck, you can follow this method. Start the unit in cooling mode, as this issue typically occurs in this mode. Then, switch the unit to fan mode using the remote. In fan mode, the outdoor fan motor should turn off, and only the indoor fan will continue running. If the relay or contactor is functioning properly, the compressor will also turn off, and the outdoor unit will stop. However, if the relay or contactor is stuck, the compressor will keep running even though the outdoor unit should have stopped. After confirming this, switch the unit back to cooling mode, and the system should restart as normal. This process helps determine if the issue is caused by a stuck relay or contactor. To observe these two situations, you need to go near the outdoor unit. If the indoor fan is running, but the outdoor fan is off, and there's no sound from the compressor, it means the relay is functioning properly. When you switch the unit back to cooling mode, the relay will activate the outdoor unit again, turning it on. This confirms that the relay is working correctly and operating as it should. Now let's talk about hot and cool models, as their situations are different, and the issues that can cause ice formation on the suction pipe vary accordingly. Let me explain how. If you have a cooling-only model, ice on the suction pipe can occur due to several reasons related to the refrigerant. 1. Low gas pressure. This happens if the refrigerant has leaked partially or completely. 2. Overcharging the system. Adding too much gas while refilling can also lead to ice formation. For cooling-only models, there are typically two scenarios. If all the refrigerant has leaked out, the system must be charged by weight. Charging by weight minimizes errors and ensures the problem is resolved. Partial gas leak. If some refrigerant is still present and more gas is added without measuring properly, it can result in overcharging, which is another common cause of ice formation on the suction pipe. This explains one situation related to cooling-only models. Each case requires proper diagnosis and handling to prevent such issues. Now let's talk about heat and cool models, as they can also have two types of situations depending on whether the servicing is done in summer or winter. Summer servicing. In summer, the situation is similar to that of a cool-only model. If the refrigerant is low, completely leaked, or overcharged, the same issues can arise, such as ice forming on the suction pipe. Winter servicing. In winter, the situation becomes more complex due to the behavior of refrigerant gas molecules in cold temperatures. 1. Low gas pressure or leaks. If the refrigerant is partially leaked, it can be difficult to determine how much gas to add, because in cold weather, gas molecules shrink. This causes the pressure reading to appear lower than usual, which might mislead you into thinking the system requires more gas. When ice forms on the evaporator, the pressure further drops, giving a false impression of insufficient gas. Charging refrigerant in winter. If the system is serviced in winter and refrigerant is charged based on the apparent low pressure without considering the molecule shrinkage, overcharging can occur. This can lead to ice forming on the suction pipe, or even cause ice to accumulate on the outdoor unit. To avoid these problems, always remove the existing refrigerant completely and recharge with fresh refrigerant by weight. Avoid top-ups, especially in winter, as they can lead to errors in the system's gas levels and potential issues like ice formation. By carefully recharging the system by weight, you can minimize problems and ensure the unit operates smoothly, regardless of the season. Now let's discuss inverters and DC inverters, specifically whether ice can form on their suction pipes. First, let's address whether overcharging the refrigerant can cause ice to form. The answer is generally no, but under certain conditions it might. I will share both my technical insights and personal experience to explain this. From a technical perspective, overcharging the refrigerant is less likely to cause issues in inverter or DC inverter air conditioners because their compressor speed is variable. The compressor can adjust its speed, increasing or decreasing as needed, which minimizes the likelihood of problems such as ice formation. Additionally, different companies equip their outdoor units with 3, 4, or 5 types of sensors. The more sensors a unit has, the greater the control, the PCB. However, in units with only 3 sensors, problems can arise because they typically lack a sensor on the suction pipe. In contrast, units with 4 or 5 sensors include a suction pipe sensor that monitors the temperature. If excessive cooling is detected, the sensor communicates with the PCB to reduce the compressor's speed, preventing ice from forming. In summary, ice on the suction pipe in inverter or DC inverter units is rare, even if the refrigerant is overcharged due to their advanced control systems and variable compressor speeds. However, units with fewer sensors, particularly those without a suction pipe sensor, are more prone to such issues. This is a Pearl DC inverter air conditioner, and it was also experiencing ice formation on the suction pipe. Initially, I assumed the issue was due to a clogged evaporator, but my assumption was incorrect, as the evaporator was clean. The owner also confirmed that it had been recently serviced. Next, I moved to the outdoor unit for further inspection. Upon checking, I noticed that one of the pipes was bent on one side. Although the rest of the pipe seemed fine, I inspected it more closely by pressing and feeling through the insulation. It turned out that the pipe was bent to the extent that only 10 to 20% of the gas could pass through. This was a significant blockage, as the pipe was approximately 70% bent at that point, causing the problem. Solution. Since the pipe was too rigid to straighten without causing damage, the solution was to cut the bent section and replace it with new joints. This ensured that the pipes were completely fresh and free from blockages. After installing the new joints and fixing the pipe, The unit was tested, and it started working perfectly. The ice formation issue was completely resolved as well. This highlights the importance of inspecting the entire system, including the outdoor unit, for physical issues like bent pipes that can restrict gas flow and cause such problems. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.